Welcome back. We are here looking at the U.S. indices and the big tech stocks in the United States. And this is going to be my daily forecast for Monday, December 28, 2020. We get into the end of the year, and usually that means that there's going to be quite a lot of action. So in the weekend, or basically in the break, the only thing that has been trading is basically Bitcoin, and the people that have been paying attention, Bitcoin has basically exploded to the upside. And this is interesting because usually US dollar trades in the opposite direction. So we could expect a major depreciation in the US dollar when that starts trading again. And that will have implication for stocks, indices, and so on, because they usually trade the opposite of the US dollar. If it starts depreciating, then the value of the indices and also stocks in commodities, precious metals, and so on, that tends to increase. So it'll be interesting what happens when the US dollar starts trading. But we'll start by looking at the Great British, S&P 500. We'll look at the Dow Jones and the Nasdaq. But before, if you like to support our channel, you're welcome to hit the subscribe button down in the corner, hit the like button and the bell button to see our newest videos, and you're welcome to join us over at Patreon. If you want access to our full technical analysis, our signal service, and also our online trades, the link is down below. So we'll look at S&P 500. As you can see, at the moment, we're trading at 3,703. We're trading above 3,700. And at this point, we are most likely going to go higher. The 20 exponential moving average has been major support in the S&P 500. Technical indicators, they are, some of them are bearish, but if you look at for example, the stochastic, which usually moves faster than the other indicators, then it is basically turning around. So we may see this a crossing on Monday or on Tuesday session, and that also means that we'll have these other indicators the following after that. So expect increase in the S&P 500 in the coming trading days. There's no interest in basically selling this, because every single time we have a drop in this market, it rallies. So a short fall of roughly 0.5% in the S&P 500 is at this point a major buying opportunity. Target at this point is 3,800 and to 4,000. And that probably is fairly not in the short run, but a median run, that will hit 4,000. So let's look at the Dow Jones. So Dow is trading above 30,000. We're at 30,199. At this point, the target for the Dow Jones is 30,500, and after that, 31,000. It is very similar to the S&P 100, the technical indicators, but they're a little bit more bearish at this point. You can see the stochastic is about to turn around, but has not fully. It's basically flat at this point. RSI is bearish, the CCI is flat, and the MACD is still bullish at this point because we're trading above the zero line, but we're trading underneath the signal line. We have a pullback from the 20 moving average here in the Bollinger Band, and that is an indication that we are basically ready to go higher. 20 exponential has been major support in this indice. Every single time we get close to that, that is basically a buying opportunity at this point. As I did say earlier, 30,500 is first the target, and then after 31,000. So let's look at the Nasdaq. So as you can see, we are at 12,711. I'm still a little bit bearish on Nasdaq compared to the other indices. We are at the 58 in the RSI, which is fairly low, but it has tend to pull back quite often. And I wouldn't be surprised if we had another go at the 20 exponential. And that is roughly at 12,505. So we could see a little bit of pullback when Nasdaq starts trading again, and then we rally toward 13,000. 13,000 is basically the short-term target. 13,500 will mostly happen within a, you know, a month or a month and a half. And then 14,000 is basically the next target. So we are in the uptrend. Every pullback towards the 20 exponential has been basically had a lot of buyers coming in and basically pushing this price up. And that is basically just a continuation. If we fall below this, then we have the 40, the 50, and also the 100 moving average here. And the 100, last time we broke down towards the 100 moving average, we had one of the biggest rallies ever in the Nasdaq history. So pullbacks towards the 20, that is basically definitely a buying opportunity. So let's look at these tech stocks. So we'll start by looking at Apple. And first of all, Apple is quite overextended. We're at 70.33 in the RSI. It is overbought at this point. We had problems getting basically higher than 135. And if we manage to break above here, we'll go and test these all-time highs here. And at this point, I think that we are just going to see a continuation of the same thing. So pullbacks towards the 20 or the 40 exponential moving average are major buying opportunities for this stock. However, other technical indicators are still fairly bullish, but I am expecting a pullback towards the 20 exponential. That is roughly to $125. That is basically your entry to a buying opportunity. No interest in basically shorting this. So we have Amazon. Amazon is trading just at the 50 moving average. These technical indicators are looking dreadful for Amazon. Technically, amazingly, I was expecting Amazon to rally significantly in this holiday season due to the fact that most people were buying their gifts online. Apparently not at Amazon, if you just look at the stock. So if you look at these technical indicators, the MACD is about to cross the signal line, the CCI, the stochastic has crossed the signal line, RSI is flat, CCI is flat, and we are basically crossing the 20 moving average here in the Bollinger Band. And usually that means that we're going all the way down to the bottom of the Bollinger Band, which is roughly at 3,100. So the closer that we get to the 150 moving average, the better the buying opportunity here. So that is basically a fall of roughly 3.27%. So let's look at Microsoft. Microsoft rallied significantly the last 4 days before we went into the holidays. And at this point, I think that we're gonna see a pullback towards the 20 exponential in the first run. And after that, we may see a test of the 50 moving average. If we get close to the 100 moving average, which is at 213, then that is basically your buying opportunity. Technical indicators are turning around for Microsoft stocks, so expect this to fall. And yes, that's one of the main reasons why I think that Nasdaq will fall, because if these major companies like Apple, Microsoft are going to fall, then they will drag the Nasdaq with it. So these are basically buying opportunities the closer we get to the 50 and 100. And I don't expect us to go much lower than that. So let's look at Facebook. Facebook, well, had a dreadful week before we went into the holidays. At this point, we are on the edge of being oversold. However, technical indicators are, well, so low at this point that they can only go higher. We are approaching, we have tested the very lows here. So 264 is basically the bottom of this market. If we manage to break above the 50 moving average, then we are going to go significantly higher. Facebook has these massive breakdowns in between. We had one here of roughly 11%. We have another one now of roughly 9.3%. And we had another one here that was roughly 19.4%. 5%, and then we rally after that. So we have this rally here, and so on. And what we could expect from this breakdown is basically a rally towards this point. So that's roughly 9%. Roughly 9%. So at this point, I'm definitely buying Facebook because I don't think that it will go lower than this. So we'll look at Tesla. Tesla started rallying on the last trading session. And at this point, I think that we're going to the all-time highs here at roughly, or my target at this point is 700. Every single time we get close to the 20 exponential moving average, we rally. And at this point, we are only at 59 in the RSI, and technical indicators are turning around. So this is a very good trade. We started trading it here, bought in at 624, and the target is basically 700. But I do believe that we are going to go beyond 700 at this point. So no one's just basically shorting this. Every single time we get close to the 20 exponential, I am buying huge amounts of Tesla stock. So let's look at Google. Google is basically the same thing. So the two companies, Facebook, Google, had a very rough time because there was a lot of bad news that's come out about these two companies. But it is ready to rally from now. That news is basically over. We are significantly oversold. Technical indicators are turning around. It is basically a perfect setup for a major rally up towards at least these highs here of 1855. That's roughly 7.33%. If we break below the 50 moving average, that opens the door to the 100 moving average. I would be very surprised if that happens. So let's look at Netflix. So Netflix rallied significantly. It went all the way from 7.97%. And then we decreased again, roughly 3.83%. At this point, we may go a little bit lower. I think that we're going to test the 40 exponential first before we rally. If you look at technical indicators, they are looking fairly dreadful. And the MACD is basically across the signal line now. The same goes for the stochastic. And the RSI is flat, the CCI is flat. And if we break the 20 moving average here, that opens the door to 40, then 50, and the 150 is basically the bottom of this market. So the lower this gets, the more I will buy of it. So hope you find this helpful. You're welcome to support the channel by hitting the subscribe button down in the corner. Hit the like button, the bell button to see our newest videos, and you're welcome to join us over at Patreon. The link is down below. Good luck and thank you very much. Thank you.